Hi, good morning, Shen.
Apologies for the poor connection, sir, but the story is still good. So why don't you walk us through how you guys are reimagining the college experience for your students? Because you, just this week, launched your breakthrough experiential global education between Mapua schools and the Arizona State University. Why don't you tell us more about this?
You're right, Michelle, no? A backgrounder, Mapua University and its daughter schools, Mapua Malayan Colleges Laguna, and Mapua Malayan Colleges Mindanao partnered with Arizona State University for its business and health science program last year. Arizona State University has been ranked by U.S. News and World Report as the number one school for innovation. It is they are ahead, actually, of Stanford and MIT over the past 8 years. Now, in addition, ASU is ranked number one in the U.S. and second in the world in 2022 Times Higher Education for advancing the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. On the other hand, Mapua University is one of the only four universities which entered the 2023 Times Higher Education World University Ranking. And Mapua has long been focused in delivering internationalized, digitally enhanced, outcomes-based, and research-driven education to its students. Mm-hmm. Now, our collaboration with a global leader like ASU will enable us to elevate this further by giving our students numerous opportunities with a top-ranked U.S. university. Mm-hmm. Now, what is unique about this partnership, Michelle, is the full integration of international, intercultural, and global dimensions in the delivery of teaching and learning, research, and community engagement activities of our higher education. Mm-hmm. Now, as an example, Mapua students will have the chance to be immersed in international learning experiences in numerous ways. So one of which is they can access the ASU curricula and digital learning assets of more than 2,000 fully online courses or subjects. Second is that students can participate in global signature classes through our state-of-the-art global classroom where they can interact with professors and classmates from member universities of the ASU and the Sintana Alliance from around the world without leaving the Philippines.
Dr. Doji, What is the price point for courses like these? And, you know, are you seeing the need to raise tuition at this point, given the add-on, the value add-on for this sort of experience, and, of course, to address inflation, which is everybody's problem now?
Well, Michelle, the good news about this is that we've done this partnership in a highly cost-effective manner, where there were practically no increase in the current fees of the students enrolled in business and health science programs.
Mm-hmm. All right. And so no plans to raise tuition. Where are we today when it comes to where education is? I mean, Dr. Doji, there was a study done that actually showed COVID-19 learning delays. In the U.S. at least, they say that two decades worth of math and reading progress erased in the U.S., because of COVID-19. What about for Philippine education? How long do you think your own students will need to be able to catch up and advance?
Oh, one of the strengths of Mapua University and its daughter school is its ability to deliver learning in multimodal mode. Now, in the recent pandemic, most of the school closed because of the inability to deliver teaching and learning in fully remote mode. But for Mapua University, since we've shifted, even before the pandemic, the Mapua University and Mapua schools actually on blended learning mode already. And when the pandemic forced us to close our campus, we immediately shifted to fully remote learning. And in that sense, I think we have not experienced significant learning losses because of the continuity of teaching and learning despite the pandemic.
And when you connect learning to earning, how are you able to ensure that the skills and the industry gap is addressed? That what you're teaching your kids today won't be obsolete in 5 to 10 years' time when new technology changes the landscape again?
We're fully aware that the job market worldwide is constantly changing and evolving. And that's why this kind of initiative has been introduced. That is just to prepare our students for any challenges that they will face in the changing workplace. Mm. We believe that this kind of partnership will broaden their horizons and prepare them for success in increasingly interconnected and diverse world.
Do you expect this new experience that you offer to attract even more students? Are you seeing or at least expecting a surge in enrollment because of the new offering?
Well, that is our hope, that more and more Filipino students would partake of this kind of unique partnership between top universities in the U.S. and the top university in the Philippines. So we're hoping that this would increase even further our enrollees in our programs, particularly in business and health science.
All right. I want to end, Dr. Doji, with the very beginning. I mean, while you offer tertiary education, we all know that the foundation for any effective tertiary education is high-quality early childhood education. It is the most effective way to close achievement gaps and break the cycle of poverty. Do you have plans to extend your services, perhaps, to early education, grade school, high school, or at least partner up?
Right now, there's no plan yet, but what I can mention is that we are already in basic education. Some of our universities are already offering high school secondary education programs. Mm-hmm. But there's no plan yet to offer basic education or elementary programs at the moment.
All right. On that note, Dr. Doji, thank you so much for joining us this morning and sharing with us this important milestone, not just for Mapua, but for the students. Thank you.
Thank you so much.